Hello, and welcome back to our TechBytes series on today's Teradata. This is our last session, and here we're going to cover what I think is most important, how Vantage allows companies to drive higher value from their analytic answers. Still Rob Armstrong, still the longtime Teradata guy, as your host. Many people say that data is worthless without analytics, and that's true, I guess, for the most part. But I'm going to take that a step further and say that analytics are useless without action. This is where you turn your data into outcomes, and that's what drives your results. You need to look at analytics as a value proposition and not a cost game. The analytic ecosystem cannot be judged by dollars per terabyte or dollar per CPU second or other convoluted TCO calculation. It's the value of success is really what you're trying to drive. Analytic ecosystems are not about getting a 10% reduction in cost. They're about getting a 10x increase in revenue. It's about the top line and not the bottom line. I've often heard the lament that Teradata is expensive. And I always wondered where they were producing that number. Well, usually it was Teradata was being compared to a much smaller, more limited, maybe a data mart type departmental system. Or for example, one customer did not include the cost of data quality in the competitor because they could not run integrated models with the competitor's offering. So why worry about data quality? Yet they included the data quality cost in Teradata because we can run a more enterprise-wide model. Or maybe there were systems that were underutilized compared to what the resources were that purchased. And all of this reminds me of a saying I have that any resource used incorrectly is expensive. But as the chart shows, the upfront cost of getting started with Vantage can be extremely low. You can get Teradata Vantage on a cloud as a DIY, and the costs are minimal. We've also introduced consumption pricing, so if you're not running queries, you're not paying for the system. Let's take a look at some of these current Vantage pricing options. We've simplified the pricing to provide for different use cases. That first option is what we call a blended pricing. So here you have fairly high and consistent demand. So you want to pay up front and get the lowest rates for known capacity. But you do have some known spikes. So maybe seasonal, end of the month, or something like that. So to meet that additional known demand, you can either purchase a large block of on-demand capacity, or you just choose to let the system accommodate it. It can extend as a new workload is added, and you will pay for that at an on-demand rate. The other option is just to be a pure consumption model. Here, you're only paying for the queries that successfully complete. If there's no queries running, you don't need to turn off or sleep the environment. You just don't get charges because nothing's executing. Any workload that's part of the general manager of the system is not charged back to you. This option is really good for those that have a sporadic or unknown workload, right? Maybe workloads for the test or a DR box where there's a burst of activity and then long periods of inactivity. But the importance is having that option of choice, because sometimes it is better to do that upfront known capacity purchase. The bottom line is that you just can't judge a system by its cost. Many vendors will have low-end pricing, they'll have great capability, and then when you go to scale, the costs increase quickly. This has been validated by a recent McKnight Consulting paper on the price performance of cloud database systems. So just a note before moving on. The other mistake people make is to think that all databases will get the same output, and that just you need to find the cheapest one. As we saw in an earlier session, that's just not true. Pay as much, if not more, attention on what you're getting and not what you're spending. To wrap up on getting value from Vantage, the real difference is how we see the world of analytics versus how others see the world of analytics. Many vendors just think having data silos and replicated data is okay, because that's how you get more users. That's how you get concurrency. That's how you get scale. And that's how you make more throughput through a system. Unfortunately, what happens is you get data drift and inconsistency between the silos, which creates more cost and confusion in your business. Add to the fact people are looking at cost and not return, the data really starts to look like a liability. And as you know, in any corporation, liabilities must be limited. Teradata believes and Vantage enables in the integration and reuse of data across the enterprise. This store once used Minitime Philosophy minimizes the cost of data while maximizing its usage. Now you combine this with Vantage's ability to access and integrate data from other storage, such as Hadoop and object storage, during the query, it only strengthens the analytic output. In fact, at one customer, they said that they have the ability to manage and analyze sets of data that drove a $1 billion return. If you can generate $1 billion, isn't it worth spending the money to get it right? And that's just a short bit on how Teradata delivers on higher value. Just a closing thought as we're at the end of our series now, and again, I appreciate you staying through the 5 sessions. I started by looking back and saying that Teradata has a legacy of being the best. I now want to look forward and tell you that we are here to help you drive your future success. Teradata Vantage is that proven modern architecture that gives you a bridge to the cloud with fast speed, low risk, and high value for all your enterprise analytic needs. And that is the end of our Teradata TechBytes series on today's Teradata. I trust you all picked up a few bits of information that was new and usable to you, and I thank you for listening. And for the last time, this is Rob Armstrong saying so long.